My name is Tahariani. I am the founder and managing partner of a small communication agency based in Antwerp. We are specialized in inclusive communications, and I would say we are the only ones who are active when it comes to inclusive communications in Benelux. We are a small team of amazing people. And in the short period, I think 4 years ago, when I was only 19 years ago, I started this agency with the intention to change the situation, to change how people perceive diversity and inclusion. And I would say it worked a little bit, because now we are working with amazing clients, with some big names. We have big projects. We can pay ourselves. So that's quite good. So the biggest question actually is, why did the big companies come to us? I was, I think, 19 years old, 20 years old. I wouldn't take myself seriously at that moment. But they came to us with a question, with a problem. They saw two things that were changing. One thing was quite logical. They saw the benefits of diversity and inclusion. But I'm not going to talk about that. I think we heard like so many talks, we read so many research, we read so many papers about that, and we know if you implement diversity and inclusion quite well in your organization, you will see some positive things. I'm not going to talk about that. But the other part is the fact that they noticed that society is changing. And not changing, but changing really, really fast. And you have then two groups. You have the consumer, the people that they are selling their products to, and you have the employees. When it comes to the consumer, I would say everyone sees a new trend. We are not anymore in a super diverse society. We are heading to a hyper diverse society, especially when it comes to identity. It would be really easy to say, my background is Moroccan, I am a male, etc., etc. But when it comes to my identity, it's way more complex, especially with the fact that we are quite connected today and that I can define my identity how I want to do that. And we see that also when it comes to gender. People don't want to label themselves as a male or as a female, and they try to find other ways. And we can go further. Our identity is also quite complex and also mixed. I can choose what I want to be today. And I don't want to give you the right to tell me who I am at one point. And I don't like that if you are going to label me at one point. And the next thing is the fact that we have the employees or the people that you're recruiting. And we are coming with a new generation. I put new because it's not new anymore when we talk about millennials. And we did recently research with VBO about the millennials here in Belgium. And 71% of them said, we want to work in a company that champions diversity and inclusion. So that's the new generation. But when it comes to the really new generation, the Generation Z, they will notice when a company doesn't have diversity, because it's really normal for them. So when they come to the companies today and they see, ooh, it's not the same as society today, they will ask some questions. And they will see that it's quite a real problem. But still, even the fact that many companies saw that there are quite a lot of possibilities, challenges, they were still struggling, especially here in Belgium and the Netherlands. And when they are struggling, the first thing that they like to do, spend more money. We don't know how to solve diversity and inclusion. We will create some side projects about diversity and inclusion. It gives me a good feeling. I feel like we are changing the problem, and it works. But I don't think it works. The second thing is giving like more and more trainings. I don't know, I wouldn't ask you how many trainings did you follow about unconscious bias or trainings about how to communicate culturally or multiculturally, but it's still not changing. Or the hopeless part is hiring a diversity and inclusion manager. I'm not saying it's bad or not positive. But if you're trying again with putting money, more and more trainings, and hiring diversity inclusion managers, and not seeing a result, then there is a real problem. And then you have to look at yourself. So, the name of the talk, of my talk was, what the fuck is inclusive communications? But before we are going to talk about inclusive communications and trying to communicate inclusively, you need a mind shift before you can understand that. And I think today, we talked a lot. There were a lot of interesting insights, but we didn't hear your story. So I know you are a little bit tired. It was a long day. and that's why I'm going to engage a little bit with you for 5 minutes, because I don't have enough time. And I'm going to ask you one question. What does diversity mean to you? Yes. Different opinions. Different ages? I'm listening to you. Different thinking. Different religions. And we can go on with trying to define diversity. But the biggest problem is the fact that many companies try to define diversity, that they narrowed the definition of diversity. If you hear the talks today, it was, I think, mainly about gender or ethnic background or maybe sexual orientation. But diversity is more than that. But I'm going to talk about that further in my talk. If I'm going to ask you, but what about inclusion? You don't have to answer this question. I'm not going to listen to you. I'm going to show you something. Take a time, look at this picture, try to feel it. And I'm going to ask you to talk with the person next to you and think about the moment that you have been excluded. It doesn't have to be something about gender or your sexual orientation. It can be a moment where your colleague didn't invite you to a meeting. It can be a moment that you weren't invited to a wedding. It can be a moment that you weren't invited to a party. So take a moment and talk with the person next to you about the moment that you were excluded. Okay, so interesting. So, yeah, what you hear at this situation is the fact that when people are excluded, they feel bad about themselves, they feel different, they feel maybe underqualified, they feel offended or insulted at one point, they feel unhappy, and it has a real impact on them. So I think we talked a lot about theories, about solutions, about metrics, about this is the quotas that we have to follow if we want to reach and have diversity in the company. But sometimes we have to humanize diversity and inclusion. And it's something else, because I can be someone who is privileged and not understand why someone is feeling the situation. But if I try to create an emotional situation and understand what's happening, it's going to put me closer to that person or what's happening. And this is really important to take with you. We talked a lot today about diversity and inclusion, but I feel at this, when you do this exercise, you feel really the feeling that you have when you exclude someone from a campaign or from a project or from something else, and it influences the situation. So, the second thing that's really important. So, this is a meme, or stock photo, I would say, but I'm going to create a meme of it. And what you see is like people who are happy together, discussing something. And what big corporate will do, because management, they are working on diversity and inclusion, they are going to think, we need this. And now we have diversity and inclusion in our team, and we are quite happy. And this is quite easy solution, because The thing that happens here is the fact that many companies, and I said that before, narrow diversity to gender, or maybe ethnicity, or maybe sexual orientation. And you can, at one point, also exclude some people. I gave a keynote once, and at one point, I got the evaluation at the end. And everything was right, 7, 8, 9, everyone was happy, and there was 1-0. I'm not happy with this presentation. And I was shocked. I thought, like, this is not happening. This is really bad. I did something wrong, or I said something really offending during the presentation. So I went to the organization. I said, please, can you track that person? Because I want to know the situation. And I found that person, and I talked with him. And he said to me, yeah, you are talking the whole time about diversity and inclusion, and I am a person with a disability, but you never talked about me during your presentation, and I felt super excluded about this topic. And I looked at him and I said, sorry, I don't know what to do, but you are totally right, and you are totally right to give me that 0, and I accept that at this point. So at one point, you can be active working on diversity and inclusion and start work groups and create like all the quotas and everything. But at one point, sometimes you forget to include some people. And you start excluding people with the term of diversity. So keep that in mind. Make inclusion inclusive again. I will give you some time to look at this one. So I saw this picture online on Facebook, I think, and I was scrolling, and I found it quite interesting. And the first thing that popped up in my mind was, big corporations, a black woman is going to apply. Diversity will never, we will never have diversity in big companies or on management level. And I said, maybe it's really interesting to look at the comments. And someone reacted, oh, we don't know if she's going to hire someone from the guys there. And it changed actually my perception. I was a little bit shocked and I said like, oh, I'm a person who is active working for diversity, inclusion, equal pay and everything. And then I see this picture and I have my own stereotypes and biases. So keep it in mind when you talk about this one. So what's really important in this situation is the fact when we are talking about diversity and inclusion, open yourself, be vulnerable. Everyone makes mistakes, it's really easy to think something wrong. And the first thing that many people will do is react quite defensive on some situations. And I had that experience also. So we were working on a project for a client, and we had to work with another agency. So, you know, two agencies together, it's not working. I say that. And we had a presentation, and that client, we worked often with that client, and they said, like, we are working now on a project, and we need your help because, yeah, we need some inclusive advice about how we can make this campaign more inclusive. And we were sitting during this meeting, and I said to them, like, I see the video. It's not quite representative. It's quite white. We have to do something with that. And I said, at the end, you see like a hand moving. Maybe we can make that hand black. And someone at the room looked at me and said, that's not natural. It's not natural. And I looked at him and said, like, ooh, I don't know what's happening here, but I mean, like, if it's white or black, I don't know if it's a link with neutrality. And I tried to explain to that person that it's quite wrong to say something like that, but he felt quite defensive, and it was like a whole discussion. And I said, like, if you don't want to learn and see what's offensive for other people, I'm not going further with this discussion. So sometimes I know it's really difficult when it comes to diversity and inclusion to talk about that and have conversation about that, and everyone makes mistakes. But be vulnerable, be human at one point, and dare to accept sometimes advice from other people. Another one is the fact, and I think that's what we did today, is talking about diversity. I'm sorry that I created memes the whole time in my presentation. We like to talk about diversity as a project, and we don't realize at one point that we are the diversity, that we are also part of the diversity. So try to change that mindset and believe that you are also part of it. not by saying, oh, we need more diversity in the company, but by saying, oh, the company is not diverse and we have to change this. Because the fact, when we are having conversations with people, and it's always, yeah, it's something that always comes up during project, is the fact that many people see diversity as a checkbox, as a side project, as something that's extra and that we have to do something about, but it's still a side project. So try to believe that you are part of it. And if you believe that you are part of it, especially with the exercise that we did today, it will be more emotional and you will understand the situation and you will also be more daring to work on it. So, the question now is, what the fuck is inclusive communications? I'm not going to answer that question because my time is over. But the most important thing that you have to take with you when it comes to this situation is be more human when it comes to diversity and inclusion. You can have a lot of quotas, numbers, everything that's quite objective, but when you don't translate it to people, to what they think, to how they feel, you are never going to change how you communicate on long term. Thank you, and see you soon.